like to welcome everyone back to another episode of Exploring Whiskies. I'm Eric.
I'm Kevin, and today we're going to be heading back over to Scotland to a kind of an interesting bottle. So this is the Aberfeldy. It's a 12-year Scotch Highland.
Highland, single malt.
Single malt Scotch. It is got a little bit of a cool history that actually plays with some of the other ones that we've done. This is was founded. Yeah, kind of an intertwine. There's a relationship here. This is one was founded. This distillery was founded by the Dewar family.
Dewars. That's a pretty recognizable name in
Scotch Isle. Yeah, people know that one. And today, and to date, I guess is the right way to say that, it is one of the primary whiskeys that they use to blend into Dewars. Founded in 1898, they are mostly known, one, for their color. That's kind of a big deal, is the Golden Dram is the name that they work with there. And they're really known for their water source.
Yep, it's all sourced locally out of the, was it, Petil Berm?
Yes, sounds right.
Very prized water source over there for the heavy deposits of golden minerals.
Yeah, gold. I thought that was interesting that they're happy that there's gold in their water.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Overall, it's traditional Scotch things, 80 proof, all that kind of wonderful, like normal stuff. But at 12 years old, looking forward to that.
Yep.
Just a straight Highland at 12 years.
So they also have a 16 and a 21 year.
Yeah, they do the normal Scotch stretch, dude. I know you're trying to finish this, but we can finish it later.
Yep. Got that honey color.
It's got that honey nose.
Yeah, it does.
That is a very sweet, malty honey. Little fruit.
Yeah,
got light fruit in there. Oh, right. That's that green apple note. Yes. Okay. That makes a lot of sense. Now, yeah, thinking through that, that a little bit of a green apple note in honey. Malt. Very nice. It's a good little nose, actually.
Yeah, it's got a good the. I have to go back to the taste. I get the, obviously the smoky, but, and it's not overly smoky, but that's the first flavor you pick up on the taste.
There is a little bit of a smoke and brine. It's not Isla level.
Yeah, it's not overpowering.
But it's there.
Like which Highlands is a medium.
I mean. Yeah, the Highlands don't tend to have that either. I mean, obviously, they could dry it out using...
Go back and get more of the apple now.
Yeah, the apple's super strong. So like a lot of scotches, aged in ex-bourbon and ex-sherry casks, that's just kind of seems to be the running theme for the most part. Every once in a while, they'll throw it in something different. But for the most, almost everything is ex-bourbon. And then a lot of sherry does show up. I really like the nose. The nose is really nice.
Even the finish now, I mean, it's... Kind of long, but very sweet.
Yeah, there's a bit of a spice that pops in the very beginning, but that all mellows out a lot. Maybe like a more of an oak tannin thing. I could see that. I wonder if they rechar. Like there's a little bit of that kind of a note to it. I'm going to guess off the color. Probably not colored. This is a pretty light for 12 years sitting in barrels.
Yep. Definitely pick up some of that color.
The nose, almost every whiskey does have that. There's either a great nose, a great palate, or a great finish. Most whiskeys don't have all three. This has a great nose. I really enjoy the nose. It's light, it's sweet, it's got the fruit, it's got the malt.
I got the apples.
The taste is good.
I'm picking up something else though on the nose. Outside of apples.
There's a lot of fruit notes on the nose. The palate does come through. There's a little bit of an oakiness to it, is what I'm going to guess. It's not a smoke the way that an Isla is a smoke. It's a different type of, it's more of a barrel char smoke.
Try to aerate it, but again, when I do that, it tends to get a little hotter, more of a smoky flavor, and then
That's the interesting part. It's 80 proof.
I know.
There's a little bit of a hot note there. Like it does drink like it has a little bit of a, there's a little ethanol kick into that. Wonder where that's coming from at 80 proof. That's kind of funny.
I don't know, but I'm interested to try the 16 and the 21.
I wonder, like, what mellows, what comes up. Actually, this makes me super interested to try Dewars. I haven't had Dewars in
a lot of years. Yeah.
It's been a lot of years since I've had Dewars, and
Dewars is one of those. It's kind of your staple in the Scotch aisle. Mm-hmm. It's one you can find in a handle.
Yep.
Kind of up there with the famous Grouse.
I really wish they had it like in a lineup like the Johnny Walker did.
Ooh, yeah.
That'd be nice. Because there's a handful of different...
Well, I'm sure if we went to the distillery,
yeah,
we'd probably get...
True. But I just wonder if there would be a lineup of Dewars, or I just think this would be a spectacular idea, and I'd mm-hmm. buy it all day long. Dewars and all the whiskeys that go in it.
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
You got to write them.
I should. I'll write marketing.
$40?
$40. Not bad. It's a great intro mm-hmm. to a Scotch. It's not overly sweet. The nose is way sweeter than the palate. It's not overly sweet, but it's a really nice, it's a pleasant drink. That's the best I have. It's a very pleasant drink. It's something that you could, it's a little lighter. It's not gonna warm you up by any means, but it's a very nice drink.
But someone that's scared of the smokiness and the peatiness, this would be
good. You're not gonna get that Mm-mm. weird ash that some people complain about. And very golden color.
Yep.
That honey lives color. Up to the name.
Yep. Overall, I think it's a solid bottle, especially for the price.
Yeah. I think it's a good price. Scotch over here does the 50s, the 60s, and still getting 80 proofs. So, yeah, definitely.
That's kind of my goal. I try to find those ones that are around 40.
Mm-hmm.
I figure that's a pretty good buy to experiment on.
Yep, you know, absolutely.
Anything more than that, I can't.
You got to know that you're going to like it.
Yeah, exactly.
That makes sense.
Our first trip down the Aberfeldy line, hopefully we can come across the 16 and the 21.
That'd be
have
nice.
Something to compare to. But if you've had it, had this one, we'd love for you to drop us a comment. Hope you enjoyed our review of it. Again, drop us a comment. We encourage you, if you did, hit that like button at the bottom of the screen.
While you're down there, subscribe to the channel. Bell icon if you want to get notified. And again, let us know. Share the video out with anybody that you think might be interested in trying a slightly, you know, not overly fruity or overly sweet, but a really nice scotch.
We'll see you on the next episode.
Thanks for watching.
Cheers.